Welcome to this video tutorial about the use and benefits of the scenario functionality in DocWeb. In this video, we will explain how to calculate different scenarios, design a single line diagram with an emergency generator, use the template functionality, and set up a link between sheets. The scenario function is available for both low voltage and medium voltage networks. By using the scenario tool, we add a new dimension to the diagram, the calculation of a network following predefined network status. With the scenario option, we can define a network operating mode for the diagram by turning circuit breakers or switching devices on and off. To illustrate this case study, we have designed a diagram with two parallel outgoings from the medium voltage switchgear feeding the low voltage part of the plant. With this scheme, the objective is to supply the entire plant with only one feeder from the medium voltage switchgear. The second feeder will remain disconnected in the normal condition as backup. In our scenario, we also want to simulate the second medium voltage feeder to be energized in alternation with the first during maintenance or failure of the supply. To create a scenario managing our second backup feeder, click on the pencil on the top right-hand corner of the screen next to the scenario drop-down menu. In the scenario window, the default scenario appears in the drop-down menu automatically created by DocWeb. In the table, DocWeb lists every breaker and switching device drawn in the single line diagram. In the default scenario, every device is closed. To change an apparatus status in open position, simply uncheck the corresponding box. In our case, we want the second feeder not energized in normal operation. To do so, start by identifying the breaker name on the sheet. Then, on the default scenario table, simply uncheck the QFB3 breaker and close the scenario window. In the diagram, the second medium voltage feeder is now gray and the QFB3 breaker status is off. This section is not supplied anymore. To activate our second medium voltage feeder for backup, for example, during maintenance, we need to create a new dedicated scenario. In the scenario window, add a name in the new scenario field and click on the save icon. For our backup scenario, the main circuit breaker will now be unchecked, whereas the second circuit breaker will remain checked to keep it active. Back in the single line diagram, we can see that the first medium voltage circuit breaker is now off, but the plant remains fed by the second medium voltage feeder. To switch from one scenario to another, use the scenario list in the top right-hand corner of the window. In DocWeb, it's now possible to calculate all the scenarios in one click. To activate this option, use the Compute All toggle near the scenario button. If Compute All is off, the calculation will only take place for the active scenario. This option is recommended for faster calculation in DocWeb. Following the previous case study, we now want to add an emergency generator to our single line diagram, in case of a failure on the main medium voltage incomer or medium voltage network. Start by selecting a generator in the common section. Add a cable and a breaker and connect it to the generator. For this case study, we have also created two new bus bars with an additional breaker. The new breakers are identified here as QF36 and QF40. To create a scenario where the emergency generator comes into action, start by deactivating the main incoming circuit breaker, QFB1. The QF36 breaker must remain checked to activate the emergency generator and feed the priority loads. In the other scenarios, backup medium voltage and default, the main incomer is disconnected. The new breakers, QF36 and QF40, are unchecked as well. We can now run the calculation for our different scenarios. Drawing a single line diagram on two or more pages is a very useful functionality for large plant design. To link a second page to a same single line diagram, find the cross-reference section under the common accordion. Select a departure item and add it to your current diagram. Then, add a new page to the project, rename it, and insert an arrival item on the new page to start designing the rest of the single line diagram. With the creation of templates, an existing single line diagram can be reused on other sheets or even new projects. To create it, draw a selection box around the desired scheme. Under the selection, click on the Save icon and give a name to your template. To insert the saved template on any chosen project, click on File, then Import Macro. From this new window, select your macro and click on Paste on Drawing to add it to the current page. You can now move your template to the existing connection on your sheet and calculate again. To access the ABB Connect Partner Hub, please visit our website at partnerhub.connect.abb.com or contact your local ABB representative.